हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू अनदर लेसन ऑफ वन अकेडमी। आई एम सोमेश उपाध्याय, आईएएस ऑफिसर, यूपीएससी रैंक 34। दिस पर्टिकुलर लेक्चर विद इन 5 स्लाइड्स विल लर्न व्हाट इज गुजराल डॉक्ट्रिन। दिस टॉपिक इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट नॉट ओनली फॉर इंटरनेशनल रिलेशंस बट ऑल्सो फॉर योर एसेज, फॉर योर हिस्ट्री, बिकॉज मॉडर्न इंडियन हिस्ट्री हैज़ दिस टॉपिक, एंड ऑल्सो फॉर योर इंटरव्यूज बिकॉज इट इंक्रीजेज योर knowledge of recent Indian history. So, what was Gujral Doctrine? Before learning the doctrines, doctrines means principles. Before that, let's learn few things about it. Number one, it was given by Inder Kumar Gujralji in 1996 when he was Minister of External Affairs in the H.D. Devagar government. Very important to remember, many people confuse that when Inder Kumar Gujral was the Prime Minister, he gave this doctrine. That is not true, and it might come somewhere in your MCQs also. Next, it is a set of 5 principles. If you remember, Panchshil by Nehru was also set of 5 principles. So we will learn that 5 principle in the next slide. And if you have not learned Panchshil, please go and watch my previous lecture on international relations. These principles are to guide the relations with our immediate neighbors. Very important to note, the South Asian neighbors with whom we share boundary. This doctrine was only for those countries. What it did, it actually recognized the importance of neighbors for regional development and also development of India. See, very easy to understand that if your neighbors are very non-cooperative, if they meddle with your life, you know, if your personal life is interfered with, then it creates problem, it creates tension inside you, and your own personal growth may get hampered because of nasty neighbors. So that is why it is important to placate, to satisfy those neighbors first. And finally, this, like I said, this idea was to placate, to pacify smaller neighbors to deal with, especially China and Pakistan, because those are the biggest nuisance in our neighborhood. So what were those 5 principles? Number one, asymmetric favor. Asymmetric favor means I will do more favor because I am a bigger country. India is a bigger country. It shares boundaries with the most of the South Asian nations, and it has stronger economy. It has larger GDP. So it decided that it will do asymmetric favor. Asymmetric means I will do bigger favor than I will expect from you. It is also called unilateral concessions. Ek tarfa favor karna hai. Unilateral favor karna hai unko. If I open my borders for the business, I don't expect them also to open the border. If I recognize Pakistan as most favored nation for my trade, we don't expect them to recognize us. And they also never recognize us as MFN. Without reciprocity. Like I said, reciprocity means what I give, I expect the same thing back. That is not there to its neighbors, especially the smaller neighbors like Bangladesh, Maldives, Sri Lanka, Nepal, all these countries, not Pakistan, remember. Second principle, no South Asian country should permit its territory to be used against the interest of another South Asian nation. How the territory is used? By harboring terrorists, by antisocial elements which create problem in another country. So we will not harbor them for creating problem in any of the South Asian nations. None of the South Asian nations will interfere in the internal affairs of one another. We have seen this in Panchshil also. Internal affairs may non-interference is one of the critical principles of Gujral Doctrine too. And then again, similar as Panchshil, that we will respect each other's territorial integrity and sovereignty. Finally, fifth principle, all the South Asian nations will settle all their disputes via peaceful bilateral negotiations, not by war or by aggression or by asking any third world power like US or China to interfere in that. It will always be peaceful bilateral negotiations. And if you remember in the principles of Indian foreign policy chapter, which we discussed previously, negotiation, peaceful negotiation is one of the principles given in the constitution. How was this applied? Gujral Doctrine had very wide application. For example, 1977 Ganga water sharing agreement with Bangladesh. We had a water sharing agreement of Ganga because Ganga originates in India and then enters Bangladesh. One branch enters, goes through West Bengal and enters Bay of Bengal. Another branch goes through Bangladesh called Padma or Padda in their local pronunciation. So in 1996, that Ganga water sharing agreement was further revised and Bangladesh got much more water than they had gotten in the previous agreement. Second, with China, we tried to freeze the border dispute in 1996. Ki border dispute jo hai, usko status quo maintain karte hain. Let us not engage in war or even standoff at the border so that we can focus on our internal development. Then one important thing was done was easing visa norms with Pakistan. Visa fee was reduced, very easily visa was being given, scrutiny reduced, so that people to people contact grows, people can come from here and visit each other's country. And also because there are a lot of marital ties, there are familial ties between the two countries, ek dusre ki family idhar udhar bat gayi hain, so they can come and meet, so that will increase people to people contact. Another example of application of Gujarat Act doctrine is the gifting of Mahakali River hydroelectricity project to Nepal. One final example I'll give you is cooperation agreements with Sri Lanka. Several cooperation agreements were signed with Sri Lanka in different fields. So these are the examples you should remember. Whenever the Gujarat doctrine question is asked, you can cite one or two from this. So what were achievements of Gujarat doctrine? Number one, it developed a sense of trust among neighbors. Jo smaller neighbors hain, they always fear India because India is so big and they have such a cultural identity is so similar that they are always in identity crisis. So they always think India is trying to grab them or dominate them. So that distrust, mistrust was reduced and a sense of trust among neighbors was built. It explored new ways of resolving issues with Pakistan. Earlier, we engaged in war because Pakistan provoked it, and there are a lot of different methods tried to ease tension with Pakistan. This was one of the new novel ways to resolve issues with Pakistan by giving them some favor and some concessions and also increasing people-to-people contact. Next achievement is it generated an atmosphere of cooperation in the region. Now everybody thought that we can grow together by cooperating with each other. So that sense was developed because of Gujarat doctrine, because it was so magnanimous, it was so large-hearted that it won over the smaller nations in the neighborhood. And another major achievement was that these Gujarat doctrines were adopted by many other major countries to deal with their neighbors. Finally, this achievement is the strategy is still used to counter Pakistan and China. Many may not accept, but Pakistan or China ko counter karne ke liye South Asian region mein we need the cooperation of all the other smaller countries like Maldives, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, Nepal, Bhutan, Myanmar also. So to get their support, even now we do lot of asymmetric favors. We give them soft loans, we engage in economic cooperation, we engage in military cooperation. For Nepal, we have opened the borders for trade. So these kind of favors we keep doing, and that is the success of Gujarat doctrine. But there are also critics of Gujarat doctrine, and those criticisms are not minor, mind you. So you should remember these criticisms. Number one and most important, and most of the criticisms are related to our relation with Pakistan. See, Pakistan's special operation desk of RAW was shut down. So that kind of compromised India's intelligence gathering abilities, because if our certain desk is shut down, that all the important assets, our deep assets in India, of India in Pakistan, deep assets means our agents or our people who are there in Pakistan, like their citizens and gather intelligence so that we can preempt, pehle se hi hum pata kar sake, any kind of mischief planned by Pakistan or any terrorist attack planned by Pakistan. That was exposed because we said ki haan hum log apna sab deep asset hata lenge, we'll not do intelligence gathering. So this was the attitude of magnanimity. It became so unreasonable that it exposed our deep assets and it weakened the raw operations in Pakistan. And it compromised India's ability to carry out covert operations against terrorists like Jaish-e-Mohammed and all those terrorists who operate from Pakistan's soil and Pak-occupied Kashmir. उनके अगेंस्ट में जो हम लोग कोवर्ट ऑपरेशंस करते थे उनको वीकेंड करने के लिए, उनको उनकी प्लान को ख़त्म करने के लिए, दोज कोवर्ट ऑपरेशंस दोज वेर कॉम्प्रोमाइज्ड. सो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ ऑल यू नीड टू नो अबाउट गुजरात डॉक्ट्रिन. इफ़ यू लाइक्ड दिस पर्टिकुलर लेक्चर, प्लीज़ सब्सक्राइब एंड शेयर विद अदर्स. एंड यू डोंट नीड टू रीड एनी अदर बुक रिगार्डिंग दिस गुजरात डॉक्ट्रिन. प्लीज़ सब्सक्राइब टू दिस चैनल एंड शेयर विद योर फ्रेंड्स. थैंक यू.